From this presentation, we will start our K-map. It is very important lecture for the person who already know what is the K-map or for the person who don't know what is the K-map. Why? Because we will see a very simple way to understand the K-map, and also for the one who just know how to solve the K-map but don't know what actually is going inside the K-map. I recommend you to see the lecture till the end. So the K-map, it is an abbreviation for your Karnaugh map. Okay, as you already know, for the logic minimization, first we have studied the Boolean algebra. So as we were already having the Boolean algebra, so why it is required to study the K-map? The reason is that the result from the Boolean algebra is not always minimum. Why it is not always minimum? Because there are some set of rules that is used by you, okay, and it is not, you know, confirmed that you are going to give a certain answer. For example, at the some point you don't know how to reduce it, okay, you don't know what the formula should I use at this particular point to reduce it. On the other hand, there is another person who is solving the same problem but know how to use the formula or the rules, you can say, and minimize it to one more step. So the answer obtained by you and that particular person is different. So that's why we cannot say that the answer is minimum by using the Boolean algebra. And also it's quite hectic and tough to solve the Boolean algebra as compared to the K-map. However, it is easy practice to do. So these are some reasons because of which we will switch to the K-map. It's very easy, less time consuming, and also the result is minimum. Okay, it is minimum but not same. We will see some examples in which the result is minimum but it is not same. So that's why a K-map is a very vast thing in the digital electronics and almost used in every topic, you can say, to minimize the circuit or to obtain the circuit from the given logic. That's why this lecture is very important, and without wasting any time, let's move to the K-map. But before moving to the actual K-map, let me make a truth table for the function, let's say the function f, and it is given as a or b c bar. Okay, this is the function given to us. We will first make a truth table by using this function, and we will obtain the same function a or b c bar by using the K-map. This proves that yeah, we can get the minimized result from the K-map in a much easier way. So let's start making our truth table first. So as you can see that I'm having a, b, c, three variables involved. So a, b, c are the three variables, and you very well know that when we are having the three variables, there are possible eight combinations. So let me write down the eight combinations. If you already know how to do this, then I want you to do it by yourself by pausing the video. 1 1 1 and 1, 0 0 1 1, 0 0 1 1, 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1. Okay, so these are the possible combinations. Now we have to see for which values of a, b and c by putting in this function the value of function f is true. Okay, so f given here is true. So as you can see that when a, b and c are 0, the function is 0. When a, b are 0 and c is 1, the function is 0 again. Okay, when a is 0, b is 1 and c is 0, the function is 1, because this thing will be 1. B is 1 and C is 0, so complement of C will be 1. 0 or 1 is 1. And when A is 0, B is 1 and C is 1, it is 0. And for all the other cases, it is 1, because A is 1 for the last 4 cases. And something odd with 1 is always 1. So this is the values of F. Okay. Now what we can do, we can form you can say canonical sum of product from this truth table. So let's make it f is equal to, we will see for the values of f which is 1. So it is A bar B C bar, A bar B C bar, or A B bar C bar. Similarly, A B bar C, A B C bar, A B C. So this is the canonical sum of product, and by using the Boolean algebra we can minimize it, and we can get this function A or B C bar. So you can see that it's very laborious to minimize this big function into the function that we got earlier. Okay, so by using the K-map, can we reduce it? Let's see. First let me reduce it by using the Boolean algebra. Okay, so what we can do, we can take A B bar common here. So A B bar common here, so we are left with C bar or C. We can take A B common here, A B, so we are left with C bar or C, and you know that C bar or C is 1. Okay, so A bar B C bar or A B bar or A B. Now you can see that I can take A common in the last two terms, and we are left with B bar or B, so that should also be 1. So I am having A bar B C bar or A. Now by using the distribution law, I can write it as A or A bar B C bar. Okay, let me write it down directly because I have already explained the rules and we will use that. A is here, A complement is here, so I'm going to write as A or BC complement. We will neglect this A complement. If you don't know how I'm doing this, then please refer to my earlier videos, because we're not going to waste the time in these all things. After all, we are here for the K-map. So as you can see that these steps are involved in getting a reduced form of the function by using the Boolean algebra. So now let's see what we can do by using the K-map. So let me do one thing, is to make a cell here, and as there are 8 combinations for 3 variables, I'm going to make 8 cells. All of them are same in size, okay, and each cell corresponds to this combinations. Okay, so we are left with 8 cells, and the cell number 1 is for, let's say this is A, here we are having BC. So cell number A is for when A is 0 and BC is 0, 0. You can say A is 0 and BC is 0, 0. So this is cell number 1. And we also know that we write it as M0, the min terms, M1, and this is the small m, M3, M4, M5, M6 and M7. So let's say this cell is your M0. Similarly, this cell is your M1. Here A is 0 and B is 0 and C is 1. Similarly, this is M2, A is 0, B is 1, C is 0. This is M3, A is 0, B is 1, C is 1. M4, A is 1, B 0, C 0. M5, A is 1, B 0, C 1. M6, A is 1, B is 1, C is 0. And then M7, all the 3 A, B, C are 1 in this case. So this is our cells, okay. Now we will arrange this cell in such a manner so that the corresponding cell, or you can say that the neighboring cell, is having only one variable changing, okay. I know it sounds a bit confusing, but let's see how we will do it. I'm making the M0 here, okay, and I will keep all these cells M0, M1, M2, M3 in the same line so that A is 0 for all of them. So let's say this is M0, this is M1, okay, the 4 cells. Here A is equal to 0, For all of them, you can see for M0, M1, M2, M3, A is 0. So I have just connected them and kept A is 0 for all of them. Now we will see for B and C. BC. Now for the M0, you can see BC is 0, 0. So this is 0, 0. For M1, the BC is 0, 1. Okay. Now you can see that in M0 and M1, only C is changing. The C is 0 here. Now in M1, C is 1. Whereas A is 0 for both of this and also B is 0. So this is what we have to do in K-map. The adjacent cells have only one variable changing. Okay, we have to change only one variable in the adjacent cell. There is a very proper reason for this that I will give you after some time when we will make this complete cell. Now you can see M2 is what? 0, 1, 0. So A is already 0 for this cell. But if I make BC as 1, 0, as in case of M2, you can see that C is changed from 1 to 0. At the same time, B is also changed from 0 to 1. So the two variables, B and C, both are changing. This is against the rule of the K-map. We cannot change the two variables in the adjacent cells. So we cannot take M2 here. Okay, it's very obvious. We will not take M2 here, but we will take M3. Why M3? Because in case of M3, the BC is 1, 1. So you can say, or you can see between M1 and M3 that only B is changing from 0 to 1. C is same, 1, 1, and A is 0. So this is the very important point in the K-map that we have to keep in our mind. And this is called the rule of adjacency. The adjacent cell have only one variable changing. That's why we have not taken M2 here. We will take M2 here, and M2 is what? 1, 0. Now you can see between M3 and M2, only C is changing from 1 to 0, whereas B is same 1, 1, and A is already same for all the cells. So this is how we will make the first row. Now we will move to the second row, in which A is equal to 1. There are 4 rows. Okay. Again, we will arrange by keeping in mind that we should not have the two variables changing in the adjacent cells. Now 100 is what? 100 is your M4. BC is 00 for this cell and A is 1. Similarly, A is 1 for this cell and BC is 01. So this is M5. And A is 1 for this cell and BC is 11. It means M7. Again, you can see here we don't have M6. Because in case of M6, the two variables are changing in the adjacent cells. So we cannot take it. And it will be now M6. Now this is how the map, or you can say that the cells of the K-map is been arranged. I know in the schools, in the colleges, when they teach you the K-map, they just draw this thing. However, they start from the two variable. I have started from the three variable, no problem. They just take these cells, okay, and then they tell you that you have to fill it like 0, 1, 2, then 3, 4, 5, 6, then 7. Okay, and you just mug it up and fill the cells in the same way throughout your life, but you don't know what actually is going inside it. That's why I made this lecture very precisely, so that you can understand this all things actually going on here. Now you might be thinking that, Sujit, you just told us that yeah, we have to make the cells and arrange it in this form, but why we are doing this? The main reason is that we have to use this property. We have to use a very important property that we learned in the Boolean algebra, is that A or A complement is equal to 1. Okay, we are using this property in these cells. Let's see how. And remember, the adjacency also follows in this way and also in this way. Okay. It means when you compare M0 and M2, M2 and M0, you will find only one variable changing. Let's see, the A is same and also the C is same, C is 0 year, C is 0 year. So A and C are 0, 0, but B is changing from 1 to 0. Similarly, if you compare M2 and M6, you will find R and C same, B and C same, 1, 0, but A is changing from 0 to 1. So adjacency also follows. This is called as the rolling of the map, or you can say that map rolling. Okay, so the adjacency follows between the two adjacent cells in this way and in this way, and also between the two end cells. Okay, in this way, these two are same, and these two are same. Same means the two variables are same, one variable is changing. So this is all about the map formation. Now we will see why we do this, and we will see the reason by using this example. So let me make a k-map for three variable, and as you can see that in case of three variable we are having 8 cells. So first you make 8 cells, then you just make a line here. This shows that you are writing BC for this upper part and A for this part, A, BC. Now we will write the corresponding values for the cell, which is 0, 0, 0, 1, then 1, 1, 1, 0, and 0, 1. You have to remember very important thing that this is your MSB, A is your MSB and C is your LSB. You have to write ABC in this way, okay, MSB to LSB. You cannot change it. If you change it, then the values or the position of the cell is changed, okay. So let's start filling it, but let me help you by writing here the min terms. This is M0, this is M1, this is M3, this is M2, M4, M5, then M6 here, and then M7. Okay, so let's fill it. You can see, let me change the color first. M0 is your 0, so you will fill 0 here, or generally it is kept unfilled. M1 is again 0, so 0 here. Now you can see M2 is 1, so 1 will be here. M3 is 0, and all the last 4 elements or cells are 1. Okay, so this is how we have to fill the K map. Now the next step in the K map is your pairing. You have to do the pairing of 2 ones, then 4 ones, then 8 ones, and then 16 ones. Okay, now the important question is how we can pair this. So let's see how we have to pair it. The most prior thing is to pair the 16 ones, but as we are having only 3 variables, there is not 16 cells, so at most we can pair 8 ones, but I cannot see 8 ones. We are having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ones, so we will move to the 4 ones, that we can pair 4 ones or not. And I can see that I can pair these 4 ones. Okay, remember, you have to pair in this way or in this way. You cannot pair diagonally. Diagonal pair is not allowed in K-map, because in diagonal the adjacency does not follow. The adjacency is in the adjacent cells and in the last and the first cells, up and the down cell. In this way, the diagonal pairing is not allowed, because in that way not only a single variable is changing, there are 2 variables changing. So this is our, let's say that give it a name. This is our first pair. Now I cannot see any more pairs of 4 ones, but I can see the pair of 2 ones in this way. So this is our priority. And remember one thing, that the same one can be paired more than one time. For example, in this first I have paired this one M6, and in this second also, let's say it is a second group of ones, in the second group of one I have again paired this one. So a single one can be paired more than once. Okay, so let's see what we have to do after pairing this. Once you have done your pairing in the priority that I have just told you, the priority 16, 18, 4, 2, then you have to just write it down as 1 plus 2. This 1 and 2 represents the group of ones called as implicants. We will see what is implicants, prime implicants, essential prime implicants. Now this one is what we have to see. You have to now listen very carefully. You have to see the group of the ones that you just made and just find in that group what are the variables which are changing. So in this group I can see that A is 1, okay, it is not changing. A is 1 throughout, it is not changing from 1 to 0. So I will write A as it is. Now I have to see for B and C. In this first cell B is 0, in the second cell B is 0, no problem. But in the third cell B is changed from 0 to 1, so B is changing. So I will not write B, because B will be 1 by this rule B is 1. Okay, now I will see for C. In the first cell C is, for this cell M4, C is 0, and for M5 C is 1, so C is also changing. Similarly, in the last two I can see that C is changed from 1 to 0, okay, and B is changed from 0 to 1. So B and C both are changing for this group of 1, that is 1. So I will not write B and C. In place of B and C I will write 1 1, plus in second group of 1s I can see that A is changing from 0 to 1, so A will be neglected, it is 1. But B and C is not changing, B is 1 and C is 0, so I will write it as B C bar. So F is simply A or B C bar, which is similar as compared to the result obtained from the Boolean algebra. I know it's a little bit confusing for you, but in the next lecture we will do some good examples which will make it more clear. But actually there is a fact that when you have to understand from the basics, or you can say that very deeply, then at the beginning it's a little bit confusing, okay, as compared to the mugging up. But when you understood the whole concept, then it will be with you throughout your life. So that's why don't get frustrated out with this lecture, it's a bit tricky, you know. So if you don't understand it, play it once more or just move to the next lecture. In that I will elaborate it, or you can say put some examples which will elaborate the topic in a much more good way. Before that I will tell you one thing. For this second group of 1, the second group of 1 is equal to what? If I just write this ones without pairing these two ones, then what I am having? A is 0, so A bar. B is 1 and C is 0, so B C bar. Similarly, for this one I am having A, because A is 1, and B is same and C is same, so B C bar. So what I can do by using the Boolean algebra, I can see B C bar is common in both of them, so I will take B C bar as common, and then I'm left with A bar or A. And you already know A bar or A is what? 1. So I'm left with B C bar. Actually we are doing the Boolean algebra here, but without, you know, actually going to the steps involved in the Boolean algebra. We are doing the Boolean algebra. Boolean algebra is the basic thing that we just, you know, molded in the form which is much convenient to understand, or you can say that much easy to solve. So actually Boolean algebra is going in all these KMaps, in this way that I have just told you. And this is the reason that we just change one variable between the two adjacent cells. Like in this case, M2 and M6, only A is changing from 0 to 1. So that's why A, when this two cells is having 1, I can pair them up and just neglect the A in this way directly that I have done here directly, because A is changing from 0 to 1, and if it is changing from 0 to 1, we are having A complement or A, that's why I can neglect it. So this is what actually goes inside the K-map. And in the next presentation, we will see some more example from the 2 and 3 variable K-map, and then we will move to the 4 and 5 variables K-map. So see you in the next presentation.